even brothers, massage your wife's feet. When was the last time you massaged your wife's feet? Put your hand up. Has anyone massaged the wife's feet before? Has anyone? If you put your hand up, then you're encouraging people to do good deeds. Have that ikhlas. MashaAllah. May Allah bless you. May Allah bless you, ya Sheikh. Wallahi, I think it's amazing. But I know many of us, we don't. Typical Kashmiris, huh? Feet? Women don't have feet. Yeah? Wallahi. Ikhwan and akhawat, massage your wife's feet. Do it for the sake of Allah tonight. Put your hand up. Another action. Homework. Who's going to massage the wife's feet? Put your hand up. You don't have a wife, ya Sheikh? You have a wife?
But I've never done it.
Well, do it today.
I can't.
Why not?
I don't know.
You can. Wallahi, ya Sheikh, you can.
Might be, but I never try, you know.
Try. Just try here. Say, wife, I love you for the sake of Allah. I've never done this before. I heard a talk today. Some little boy was giving me a talk. And he said some few good things, maybe. And he told me to massage your feet for the sake of Allah, so I get reward, and because it would encourage me to love you more. She'd be like, well, she'd probably do things to you that you never imagine. Wallahi Azim, yeah? She'd be here, have your best curry today, yeah? Do you see my point? Do it. Does it work, Isha? Do you get the respect of your wife? Of course you do. She loves you more, yes or no? Wallahi, what a humbling experience of massaging the feet of your wife. Wallahi. What about your mother? Even more important. Paradise is under the feet of your mother. Do it. See, ikhwan and akhawat, in order for us to transform and change, you don't aspire. Don't say, I'm going to change, I intend to change. Change never works that way. Change is when you be. You be, you do, and you become. This is the psychology of Umar ibn al-Khattab radiallahu anhu. Cry in the last third of the night. If you can't cry, pretend. And when you keep on doing it, it will become part of you, then you'll have sincerity in it. You be, you do, and you become. Don't think, do it. Like Shaykh Adam says, even if you think you don't have ikhlas, pretend to have ikhlas. Do the deed anyway. And then ikhlas is not you press a button, now have ikhlas. Ya Allah, I'm doing it for your sake, and that's it, you've done it for his sake. No, words are not ikhlas. It's where your heart lies. And Shaykh Adam makes a beautiful point. Don't stop the deeds, don't let shaitan win and think, oh, I'm not sincere, so I'm not going to do the deed. Do it. And keep on having Allah in mind. Do it and continue it and be continuous. So you be, you do, you become. So even if there's no ikhlas in it, you're hesitant, you know, we've got that pride. Just do it. Do it. Khalas, do it. And then once you keep on doing it, you do, then you become. It will become part of you. Honestly.